What made you decide to remove Bundy when you did at 80 pitches there?
Well, we thought in the fifth we saw the velo drop and a bunch of 87s on the board and a little lack of command so that's why we took him out there. You know, bringing in Noah, who's stretched out to pitch a few innings, been throwing the ball really well, and just wasn't his day.
The velo is down like that, and I think it was 88, 89 almost the entire game. What does that say to you, and is there a concern about what his situation is?
Yeah, that's why he's so broke, go out there, right, in the fifth. Lins went out there, then broke, goes out there because the velo was down. And just making sure he's okay. He said he was okay, but just didn't look right for us. And so that's why we took him after five.
Did anything come up after he left?
No.
That was a concern?
No.
His fastball has been, you know, he's had the home run problems that he's had, and most of it is on the fastball. I mean, is there a through line that you've seen since you got here as to what the issue is? Like a through line, something that connects all the, you know, the home runs on fastballs in your mind?
I just see fastballs that are thigh high, you know. I think, you know, once he got through that first and started really pitching, I thought he pitched well second through the fourth inning. I thought he used his off-speed stuff really well, and then his fastball played up because of it. But in the first there, for me, he was just trying to establish his fastball, and they were being ultra-aggressive and trying to ambush him, and Pujols did. LaStella did early. So I just think that from the second on into the fifth, I thought he pitched well by utilizing his four pitches. And in the fifth, it just looked like he fatigued a little bit or whatever it was. But the velo went down and his command went down.
We had a stretch here where you got a lot of games in a row, so you could even like tinker with him probably as far as like pushing back a day or anything like that. Is there anything in your mind as far as monitoring him the next couple of days?
Yeah, I mean, we're going to monitor all of our guys. So, I think we'll talk a lot. And I haven't talked to him since the game has been over, but I talked to Ebel, and yeah, everything checks out fine. We monitor our guys on a regular basis. And, yeah, we do have quite a few in a row here. And, we'll play it by ear.
The offense, you got a home run from Smith first inning, and then after that, not a lot going on.
Yeah.
What did you see?
It was a really good game until the sixth there. I thought both teams were playing well, and it was a 3-2 game. We had Harvey kind of on the ropes. They had somebody up in the third or fourth. Got his pitch count up. They had their bullpen ready. They have a good bullpen, and they have some good arms. And they rely heavily on those guys. Their starters don't go very deep. So those guys have been pitching well for them. And, yeah, we just didn't get to their pen. You know, they got to our pen. We didn't get to their pen. So, I mean, I'm just looking for guys to step up out of the pen and be able to pitch in 6 through 8 type innings with the score close. And we have it's pretty open for who wants to step up and be a guy.
You've seen a lot of pool votes over the years, and I assume then you're not surprised that a 39-year-old can hit two and drive in 3 runs and make it look pretty effortless.
Yeah, I've seen it before. Yeah. One of the best right-hand hitters of all time, right? So make mistakes to him, and he's been swinging the bat well, too, coming into the series. And, he is who he is because what he did today.
For 1 second, in your experience, is it easy to make a connection between a guy who has his longest outing of the season, his last start, and then fatigues a little bit in his next one?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I don't want to dive too far into it just because I don't have all the details, and I haven't really talked to anybody since the game has been over. He threw the ball really well for 7-plus innings his last start, and thought he threw well from the second inning into the fifth tonight or today. But I don't know if that had anything to do with it. I hope not. But, yeah, it just looked like he wasn't sharp in the fifth inning and his velo was down. And so, but he gave us a chance. Pitched five innings, 3-2 game, and we just couldn't stay right there.
You say that Shohei is a good hitter last night, and that he shows what he has, he can do today. So how do you see him today?
Yeah, just like I saw him yesterday, except he hurt us a little bit more today. Yeah, no, he's going to be a great player in this league for a while, and yeah, he's just a special athlete and hitter, and it looked like his rhythm and timing was a little bit better today, and hoping that. It gets a lot better a couple days from now.